Well, there is confirmation that we've had three finals. And the next match on court features Indonesians. And just listen to the reaction of the crowd. Because Vita Marissa and Nadya Melati will take on the world number ones, Wang Xiaoli and Yang from China. Doubles, like all other disciplines, has had its surprises this week. But I personally have to say how lovely it was to see four different nations represented at semi-final stage. Of course, apart from the Chinese and the Indonesians, we had Japanese and Danes in semi-finals. So a real international flavour. Well, the Mexican wave going round the Istora Stadium. Yeah, there's our loyal fan dressed up in his costume. He's been here every day. Saying women's doubles has had its upsets, or at least the number two seeds being beaten in the second round by the Indonesian pair in today's final. We also lost the number three seeds in the very first round by Yuki Maeda and Satoko Suetsuna. Lost Jun Kyun Yun and Kim Hana. Career in the first round. There he is, all dressed up. Yeah, been here every single day. Entered into the spirit of it. So here come our court officials, led out by Susan Taylor from Australia, who will be the umpire. Grace Chia from Singapore, the service judge. Chinese players will come out first. They are the current world number ones. Number one in the world, having only played nine tournaments. To be announced. This their sixth final, six tournaments played this year. Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang only once failed to win a tournament in which they played this year. That was the Malaysian Super Series event. Wang Xiaoli, the 21-year-old, and her more experienced partner, Yu Yang, Olympic champion in women's doubles. Vita Marissa Marissa and Nadya Melati. Going to struggle to be heard across all the noise of the fans here. What a wonderful, wonderful atmosphere. Chinese pairing who only formed their partnership last year after playing against each other in the final of the World Championships. Yu Yan won that world title to go with her Olympic title with Du Jing, but has since teamed up with Wang Xiaoli, and my goodness, 10 tournaments since forming their partnership prior to this. 9 finals, 7 titles. The only time they didn't reach the final was in the first round. Wang Xiaoli collapsed on the floor, had to be carried off court. So there's our match officials. Susan Taylor. Grace Cheer, Australia and Singapore. So the Chinese pair achieved so much since forming their partnership. 4 titles this year. And for the Indonesians, not seeded. World ranking up 6 places from last week to number 18, and their world ranking is going to shoot up again. Their win-loss record for the year prior to this tournament was 3-5, a negative win-loss record. So who would have thought they'd be in the final? But when you look at who they've beaten, including the world number 2 ranked pair, Cheng Wensing and Chen Yuqin in the second round, and then yesterday in the semi-finals against the number 4 seeds, Mizuki Fuji and Reika Kakiwa, and they didn't just beat them, 12-12. It was a very one-sided affair. I have to say, Vita Marissa was absolutely on fire, controlling the front of the court. So Wang Xiaoli, 21, her partner 25, and number 1 in the world. And look at that win-loss record for their careers, 41-1. Well, only pushed the full distance in their quarterfinal against the Koreans, the number 5 seeds, Ha Jung and Kim Min Jung. Got the opening game there, but came back 10-11 in the second and the third. Well, Ian, this is the first time that the two pairs have played against each other. But, I mean, you have to say what wonderful things these Indonesians have done this week. But despite the fact that they've been playing unbelievably well, you've still got to put the Chinese down as absolute favourites.
Well, the Indonesians have had a great week. They've thrived on the support they've got in this stadium, in their home stadium. But this Chinese pair, we've spoken of it in previous tournaments, Jill. I mean, they're taking ladies' doubles to a new level. They're a fantastic pair. And this is going to be really, really tough. They're going to need every little bit of support from this crowd to get themselves into this game, because this is a really, real big ask.
Vita Marissa is the oldest player on court at the age of 30, her partner 24. And Vita Marissa was the last Indonesian to win the title here.
On my left, Wang Xiaoli, Yu Yan, China. On my right, Vita Marissa, Nadya Melati, Indonesia. Yu Yan is third to Vita Marissa, love all.
So the world number ones. Well, I think you can safely say that sort of noise is going to greet every single point that the Indonesians win.
interestingly there, Marissa, directing play straight onto Wang Xiaoli. It has been a slight weakness in this Chinese pair this year. Wang Xiaoli at times has just looked a little bit nervous. If she's ever going to be nervous, it's in a stadium like this, and maybe that's a sign of it.
Yes, of course, this is her first experience in a final at the Indonesian Open, Wang Xiaoli. Yu Yang has played here on many an occasion. In fact, Yu Yang was former champion here back in 2007, playing with her Olympic winning partner, Du Jing. Channel attack from Yu Yang, so effective towards the forehand side of Vita Marissa, and she was weighted committed to the backhand defense.
Again, Marissa going straight for Wang Xiaoli as she moves forward. Too hard, showing a lot of experience there, Yu Yang. It's a red hot atmosphere, but she played with good control there. Handled into the center.
Yeah, and I did notice that the Indonesian defenses were very, very deep in court. Oh, this hit there from Yu from Wang Xiaoli. And she should have really put it away, and that is a real sign of the nerves.
Yeah, I'm sure that'll be the target for this Indonesian pair. Yu Yang, over the last few years, has probably been the outstanding ladies' doubles player in the world. Wang Xiaoli not really proved herself at that level yet.
Yes, and just picking up on that point, Ian. Yu Yang last year, 7 titles with 3 different partners. There was a bit of a common denominator. Anyone she played with, she seemed to win with.
Yeah, she's an outstanding player.
Oh, that's a brilliant serve. Oh, it's called a fault. Struck above the waist.
I was going to say, I think Marissa might have gone a little bit early there, determined to get some pressure on return, but saved by the service judge. Down again, looking for Wang Xiaoli. It's interesting, Yu Yang doing a lot of talking at the moment. Xiaoli, 1 or 2 errors early on. On Wang Xiaoli, but this time she was up to it. And the difference is that when Yu Yang gets in the rally, she's so clinical.
Oh, has found the back corner. That's super. Therefore, Nadya Melati, this her first major international tournament final. That's quite a step up, isn't it? It'll be interesting to see how she actually reacts to this.
Rooted to the spot in defence, didn't move a feet. The body shot.
Oh, this finds the line. That's the difference. Now, once again, lots of encouragement, lots of talking. Very good play from Yu Young.
Very controlled, switching the attack right and then left.
Once again, just look how deep the defensive stance was for Melati. 2-point advantage then to the world number ones. Good way through the opening game. Both these partnerships very much have a commander of the two. For the Indonesians, it's Vita Marissa, twice former champion here, 2008 with Liliana Natsia, who's going to be in the next final, mixed doubles. Yeah, she also won the title 10 years ago, Vita Marissa, with Diana Lomban. Vastly experienced.
That's unlucky.
13-9.
Well, close call.
I wasn't convinced by that.
Just look to run this for the Indonesian pair. Just losing contact.
Five straight points in the Chinese. Make that six.
That's a very good point. Sure serve, good racket work afterwards, getting the racket up and taking it off the top of the tape.
Seven straight points now. And one just senses this is the decisive move of the opening game. Oh, right idea, but just overcooked it. Was 17-9.
That's a big run of serving though from Wang Xiaoli. I'm sure that will have settled their early nerves.
It's a good serving again, isn't it?
Yeah, they're under pressure on return of serving. The Indonesian pair haven't really got any answers at the moment. Can't get into the rallies. Not getting any attacking opportunities at the moment. They're forced into a defensive return. That's not going to be good enough. Got to be more aggressive than that on return of serve if they're going to have a chance of turning this match around.
10 game points to the world number ones.
Shot.
That's lovely. Perhaps just delaying the inevitable, one suspects, but I think the more the Indonesians can gain a little bit of confidence, if they can just extend this opening game a little bit more.
Yeah, still one or two mistakes from Wang Xiaoli. Again, they'll be turning around to play at the slightly easier end game, and where they've won a lot of sets this week. It's going to be an out.
Yep, and with it, the opening game. 21-12. Umpire confirming the scoreline. And just 11 minutes of play.
Statistics are going to be heavily favouring the Chinese, I think. Yeah, net winners, that control of the net is the key area at the moment. Both the Chinese girls have got very, very good serves. They're concentrating on those short serves at the moment, and they're getting at winning a lot of attacking opportunities from those service and return situations. And that's what Indonesian coaches have probably got to concentrate on in this break. Find some solutions on return of serve, create some attacking opportunities from this better end. See if they can get some pressure back, particularly on Wang Xiaoli.
So what are you recommending on the return of serve? Push deeper into court? Because, quite frankly, the Chinese, when they've served good serves low, they're really looking for the next shot reply.
I think it depends who's serving. I think when it's Yu Yang serving, they want to go away from her, try and push down the sides, put the pressure on Wang Xiaoli early in the points. And it's Wang Xiaoli serving. I think Marissa in particular should probably be trying to take her on in the forecourt. Maybe Marissa's got a slight advantage there with all the mixed experience over the years.
Yeah, of course, Vita Marissa has also been in two mixed doubles finals here at the Indonesian Open. 2001 and 2002 with Nova Widianto. Having taken the opening game in convincing start, 21-12. Chinese have started the second game in just as much control. Opening rally.
Yeah, noticeable there. She took a slightly more aggressive stance. She's got to return position up a little bit. The net cord.
Well, it's a bit like the men's doubles. We witnessed the first match with Kai Yun and Fu Haifeng. Both these Chinese players are so eager to encroach in on the net. They're looking for every opportunity they possibly can.
Yeah, and that's what we were saying a little bit in the warm-up at the beginning of the match. They play a very different style of ladies doubles to that we've seen in the last few years. They're much more aggressive, much more attack-minded. A very good organisation again, good rotational play, getting Yu Yang into the front of the court. Zhao Li playing a good variety from the rear court.
Good drop shot. Yeah. Well, this is a lucky net cord, but the whole rally had been built well by the Indonesians.
Well, it's a bit of a telling factor. The 2 points the Indonesians have won in this game have both been net cord so far. They haven't actually won an open play rally.
good serve.
But it's a solid return. She knew it was a good serve, so she pushed firmly to the rear court. Put the pressure on the younger Indonesian player. She couldn't respond.
Yeah, probably the sort of return that he was suggesting that the Indonesian should use. That's well long of the back line.
Yeah, I mean, she's trying to be more aggressive, but she just hasn't really got the control there. It was a good serve, it was below net height, so she's pushing up. And in this hole, that equals out of the back of the court, I'm afraid. Even Marissa forced into a defensive return, and she's a good returner of serve normally.
Yeah. Serve is fault called, once again struck above the waist, says Bruce Chia. I have to say, Grace Chia has been very hot on the serves this week. She's called a number of faults, hasn't she?
Yeah, I think the players will accept that. She's consistent, and I think she has been consistent.
Yeah, I agree. And you and I have talked many a time about how high these serves seem to be coming. Of course, the rule says that it's got to be struck below the waist, but the waist is defined as below the lowest rib.
And again, that quick return into the rear court posing some problems for the Indonesians, particularly with Yu Yang following in to take the net position.
Oh yes,
I'm afraid the only return so far is two net cords and a service fault. The only 3 points the Indonesians have managed to win so far. It's a sign of the pressure they're under from this very impressive Chinese pair.
Yeah, and when they are defending, they have the ability to drive the shuttle back as Wang Xiaoli did on that occasion, turning their defense into attack. Oh, that's good again. No, she's missed it.
First mistake. Yeah, against a pair like this, you don't get many opportunities. At 9-all in the first game, I just felt Wang Xiaoli was a little bit nervous, and there was a slight opportunity. It was a small window of opportunity, it has to be said. And I'm afraid they're really up against it now.
Yeah, 7 points adrift at the mid-game interval. Yang and Wang Xiaoli, a bit like Li Chongwei, giving a demonstration, a masterclass.
Well, just as Li Chongwei is the best men's singles player in the world, he's a far and away the best ladies' doubles player in the world at the moment.
Crowd here in Istora Stadium desperately trying to lift the Indonesian players.
I'm afraid they haven't really got the weapons to hurt the Chinese pair. The Chinese pair are fully aware of that now and playing with a great deal of confidence. It's going to be very difficult to break their game down from here.
Yeah, I'm going for shots, ambitious shots that really aren't on or before they've really built the rally, worked the openings. That's a better return. That's the sort of return you were wanting.
Yeah, quicker return down the side there, puts her in a good position, gives her time to get into position, get her racket up. And she's so good in that position.
Over.
it's not for lack of effort from the Indonesians.
No, I'm afraid they're just being outplayed at the moment. They've had a great run this week. They've played some fantastic matches, but also the amount of physical effort they've had to put in throughout the rounds as well, I think, is maybe told a little bit as well. They look a little bit jaded on court today.
Yeah. Prior to this tournament, they'd never been in even a semi-final of a Super Series event. A couple of semi-finals of other events, the Malaysian Grand Prix and also the Indonesian Grand Prix Gold event. We'll need a bit of running repairs to the carpets around at the back of the court. So this is a huge leap forward for them, and it will be a huge confidence booster. Whether they can actually turn this around, I have my doubts.
Their opponents are too strong for them today, but they've got to take heart from a fantastic run. Beating the number two and the number four pairs in the world in one tournament is a fantastic result, particularly as you say, they've not had a particularly good record in the Super Series level events this year. They should certainly view the week very positively.
Yeah, when you think about the All England final that Yu Yang and Wang Xiaoli played against Mizuki Fuji and Reika Kikiwa, they're absolutely blasted their Japanese opponents off court. Didn't get double figures in either game. So, you know, okay. It's a tall order from here, and they look as if they've got their backs against the wall, but they have got double figures in the opening game. It's no disgrace, as you have pointed out. This women's doubles pair are clearly the number one in the world at the moment.
They won't be the only pair this year. Receiving end of a tough match like this from this pair.
It's a super serve again. And that's well long of the back line.
Yeah, there's pressure from the first shot. They both serve extremely well. They look to put pressure on from that very first shot. It's a better return from Marissa. Creates the attacking opportunity.
Good defense.
Great defense.
Yeah, Chinese pair really are pressurizing Melati.
Melati trying to go at the Wang Xiaoli defense, but Wang Xiaoli's relaxed now. They've got a good lead. She's playing freely, not making the mistakes she was at the beginning of this match. Did the net court again. Seems the only way through this Chinese pair at the moment.
Service over, 6-15.
And she nearly got that back.
Every time the Indonesians wear a ball. In a point, the mascots in this arena leaping in the air, getting the crowd going. That's a good serve. Yeah.
8-15. Service over. 16-8.
Wow, this is good fighting spirit from the Indonesians.
A little bit, didn't move her feet to it.
Service over, 17. 9.
That short return to Wang Xiaoli.
Service over. 10-17.
To return.
That's so clever.
Service over.
Reading the situation, knew where the shuttle was going to come. She was ready and waiting. I knew that a simple block would suffice.
Yeah, it takes the shuttle so early. Melati had been driven back with the power smash from the rear court. Yu Yang using that to good space at the front to good effect.
19-10.
She's quick in.
Oh, it's unbelievable, isn't it?
Reads 20, the situation, quick in. One fix to the body and the block to the front.
So that wonderful net shot, and it's match points. She's missed it.
Game.
21-12, 21-10. And the brave run of the Indonesians has come to an end. World number ones, Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang, just a class above Vita Marissa and Nadya Melati. Under 30 minutes of play. My goodness. Well, from 9-all in that first game, it was all one-way traffic and all in favour of the Chinese pair. Confirmation of the score, just 18, well, it says 18 minutes of play. Not sure that was right, I thought it was nearer 27-28. Anyway, confirmation of the score, 21-12, 21-10.
Statistics are probably going to be a bit one-sided there. I'm sure they've come out right, because there were a lot of overhead winners and a lot of net winners from the Chinese in that game, totally dominating that front court area.
Thank you.
Well, for the Chinese pair. Yeah.
Thank you.
Fifth title of the year to go with the Super Series finals. Korean Open, All England, and Open Badminton Championships. And I think this time I'm getting it right. They're undefeated in Premier Super Series events. Got it all wrong before. Got too excited by it all here in Istora Stadium. But they really are undefeated in Premier events. They won the Korean, won the All England, and now they've won the Indonesian Open. Only time they've been beaten this year was in the final of the Malaysian Super Series event, lost out to their teammates Zhao Yunlei and Tian Qing. We'll be seeing Zhao Yunlei in our next match, the mixed doubles. She, of course, is number one in the world in the mixed doubles with Zhang Na, and they'll be up against the Indonesians. Toei Akbar and Liliana Maxia. Fresh on the back of three titles from three tournaments. Can the Indonesians keep that run going? Well, before we'll get that answered, we'll have the prize presentation for the women's doubles. The players are led forward. Yeah. Yes, that's nice to see. Genuinely nice congratulations between all four players. CEO of Osum Indonesia presenting the medals. And the fifth title of the year for Wang Xiaoli and the checks from Yan Ariadi, director of Djarum. From the Badminton Association of Indonesia, head of logistics.
Ha ha ha.